Now that we know what doping is, let's see how we can determine the charge carrier concentration in doped semiconductors. Once we do that, I will also show to you how to calculate the position of the Fermi levels of doped semiconductors as well. As we saw in a previous video, the product of electron and hole concentrations in a semiconductor is independent on the position of the Fermi level energy. This same equation can be applied for doped semiconductors. You can remember that N is the concentration of electrons that occupy energy states in the conduction band. P is the concentration of holes that occupy energy states in the valence band. And I is the intrinsic carrier concentration. Capital NC and capital NV are the effective densities of states in the conduction and valence band respectively. EG is the band gap. KB is the Boltzmann constant and T is the temperature. Such relation is called the law of mass action for semiconductors. Though the values of N and P will change under doping, their product will still be equal to the square of the intrinsic carrier concentration, Ni. Let's work out how to calculate the charge carrier concentration from a given dopant concentration. We will use an example of an N-type silicon at room temperature that has a donor concentration of 1 times 10 to the power of 18 phosphorus atoms per cubic centimeter. Since we are at room temperature, we can assume that all the dopants are ionized. We can recall that the intrinsic carrier concentration of undoped silicon at room temperature is 1 times 10 to the power of 10 carriers per cubic centimeter. It is clear to see that the dopant concentration here is orders of magnitude higher than the intrinsic carrier concentration. Therefore, the intrinsic concentration essentially has no effect on the electron concentration. We can equate the electron concentration to the donor concentration. N is then equal to 1 times 10 to the power of 18 electrons per cubic centimeter, since each phosphorus atom donates 1 mobile electron. We now have N, but how do we calculate P? We use the mass action law from the previous slide. With this relationship, we can easily calculate that the concentration of holes, P, is equal to 100 holes per cubic centimeter. When we compare the concentration of electrons to the concentration of holes, we clearly notice the enormous difference in the numbers of electrons and holes that are present in this example of N-type silicon. We can do the same calculation for a P-type semiconductor with a given acceptor concentration. I won't step through the entire solution here. The only key difference now is that we can set P equal to the acceptor concentration and solve N through the mass action law. This is because we can assume that at room temperature, all boron atoms are ionized and each boron atom contributes with a hole. We have seen how doping can manipulate the concentration of electrons and holes in semiconductor. We also know that due to the mass action law, when one type of the charge carrier is increased, the other type is decreased. We call the carriers whose concentration is much larger than that of the other type majority carriers. These are holes in P-type materials and electrons in N-type materials. Minority charge carriers are the carriers with much lower concentration than the majority carriers. These are electrons in P-type materials and holes in N-type materials. From the concentrations of charge carriers, we can calculate the position of the Fermi level. Here we see the Venn diagram of an N-type semiconductor. we are interested in the difference between the conduction band and the Fermi level. We calculate it by recalling this equation from a previous video. We can see that the quantity EF minus EC is present in the equation. We expect that the Fermi level is below the edge of the conduction band EC. Therefore, this quantity should be negative. Or in other words, the position of the Fermi level is negative with respect to the position of the edge of the conduction band. Let's use the example from the previous slide where N equals to 10 to the power of 18 per cubic centimeter. We know that the effective density of states in the conduction band of silicon. From here, solving the Fermi level is quite straightforward, and we end up with a value of minus 0.09 electron volts. This means that the Fermi level is only 0.09 electron volts below the edge of the conduction band. We can use the same process to solve the Fermi level position in a p-type semiconductor. This time we are interested in the distance between the edge of the valence band and the Fermi level. We expect that the Fermi level is close to the valence band. We use the relationship to calculate the concentration of holes in which the effective density of states in the valence band NV is present. The value for the position of Fermi level with respect to the edge of the valence band is plus 0.19 electron volts, which means that in this case the Fermi level is above the valence band. Now to recap. In this video, you learn how to calculate the charge carrier densities and the positions of Fermi levels in semiconductors for a given doping level. In real semiconductor engineering, we often use these relationships to calculate the concentration of carriers, since several measurement techniques help us to determine the position of the Fermi level in a material. From there, you can work backwards to calculate the dopant concentration of the material. I invite you to try this out on your own.